New tech for me usually peaks during that honeymoon phase where it's new and shiny and exciting, but pretty soon after that, after you've had it for a little while, that shine starts to wear off, and then it just becomes like everything else. It's either no longer exciting to me at all, or I just stop using it altogether and end up selling it. But I bought this iPad Pro in 2018, and I've been consistently using it ever since then, to the point now that I rely on it for running my photography business, my YouTube channel, managing all of the different schedules as a husband, a father, a photographer, all of the different hats that I wear. So today I'm gonna share how I use the iPad Pro just in my daily life, where it kind of fits in my life. Some of the apps that I use that I can recommend for anybody who might be looking for something similar, and just kind of share some thoughts on how it works for me as someone who has always preferred pen and paper. And this might be a little bit longer, so I'm gonna break it up and have timestamps down below where you can actually click through to any particular part that you might be interested in, but let's get into it. Photography. This is probably what most of you who are subscribed to the channel, what you're actually interested in and hearing about the iPad Pro. For photographers, what's it like to edit photos and manage files on the iPad Pro? It is great to edit photos on the iPad Pro. It's really enjoyable, but it's definitely not perfect for just any scenario or any photographer. When we first got iPad OS, that was like a game changer for the iPad, especially for people who are using external hard drives, because now you can plug in an external drive, move files back and forth to and from the iPad, and you could just organize all of the files directly on the iPad. You didn't have to have everything scattered throughout your camera roll, which was always just a headache for me. I can import my files directly off of an SD card. I can then move the files back and forth to an external hard drive, and I could also just import my photos through Bluetooth using the Leica Photos app, which that app is great. You can download your full resolution raw DNG files directly through the app through Bluetooth. It's awesome. I use that all the time. Now, post-processing in Lightroom is great, but only for small batches of photos. I did all of the editing work on my photos for social distancing, my zine from last April. All of that was done on the iPad Pro because at the time, my MacBook Pro had a crushed screen thanks to my son Elliot, who was 3 at the time. But I love the tactile feel of editing on the iPad Pro. It's just a different way of interacting with your photos and making those adjustments. It's not the same thing as holding a print in your hand, but holding the tablet in your hand and working with it with your hands, it's probably the closest thing you can get to that feeling if you're working digitally. Now, I say it's great for small batches of photos because you're using Lightroom CC, which is not the same as Lightroom Classic CC, which is what I use on my MacBook Pro. Lightroom CC has come a long way, but it's still limited to what you can do compared to Lightroom Classic. So if I'm dealing with hundreds or even thousands of images, say for a wedding or any commercial project, I'm gonna do all of that on my MacBook Pro using Lightroom Classic CC because it has more power, and I'm also gonna be able to use different Lightroom catalogs, keep things organized a little bit better, and also just batch edit a lot faster. But for small batches of photos, I actually prefer using the iPad just because I enjoy that process of working with the photos in my hand. I've been working on a new personal project for the last couple of months, and all of the editing work that I've been doing has been on the iPad Pro, so I can back things up to external drives, obviously, but I've just been doing all of the editing work and just kind of sitting with the photos and really studying them on the iPad Pro just because I really like that workflow. Now, I only have the 256 gig version of the iPad Pro, so I don't sync my Photos app to the cloud like I would with my phone, so the only photos that are on the iPad are from the SL2 because that camera has a massive resolution, and the 256 gig can fill up pretty quickly. So I keep everything off of it except for the project I'm currently working on, which I think is kind of nice as well because it keeps me a little bit more focused. I don't have photos from a million different things all over the place. It keeps it nice and neat, and yeah, I just really enjoy working with the photos in that way. There's obviously a ton we could get into with photography applications, but that's really the gist of it. I can organize things in the Files app, I use Lightroom CC for any editing, and that's pretty much it. If you have any questions or suggestions or anything of your own, leave them in the comments. I'll be happy to talk about it more there, but for the most part, that's really how I use it for photography. Productivity. This is where the iPad Pro really shines for me. The iPad Pro by itself as a tablet is great and it's extremely powerful, but if you pair it with the Apple Pencil and the Magic Keyboard, it really just kind of evolves what this thing can do and it becomes like a brand new thing. For general note-taking, I use two different apps and two different methods. Bear is my go-to app for typing out long notes. If I'm working on a video outline, this is where it happens. I never really script my videos, which I'm sure most of you are probably well aware of that, but I like to type out a general idea of what I want to go over for each video. For this, Bear is great with the Magic Keyboard because it just feels like I'm sitting at a computer and I'm typing out normally, and this keyboard is really enjoyable to use. And just Bear's UI in general and the customization, it's really minimal, really clean, there aren't really any distractions. It's just great when I'm kind of in a specific mood and I have ideas and I just want to get it all out there quickly. The keyboard and Bear, that's my go-to. For any handwritten notes with the iPad, I've tried a number of different apps, but I always end up coming back to Notability. It's pretty customizable and you can organize your notes in a lot of different ways, but this is like my favorite way to just jot things down quickly, whether I'm on a call with somebody, in a meeting, flipping through a book and I have an idea for something and I want to jot it down quickly. The Apple Pencil and Notability is perfect. Also, for anyone wondering, the screen protector I have on here is from Paperlike. It's meant to make the iPad feel a little bit more like paper when you're using the Apple Pencil because it has sort of this matte texture that gives the Apple Pencil just a little bit more feedback. And I'm still not really sure how I feel about this thing. It feels great when you're writing with it. It's definitely better than just using, you know, the bare glass of the iPad. But I go back and forth on this all the time. It does look pretty good. It looks way better than the original Paperlike. The original one, photo and video just looked a little bit different. You would get these weird colors because of the light that was passing through. They fixed all of that. It looks amazing and it has this nice matte finish that you don't get fingerprints as easily. It also cuts down on the glare, but again, I just cannot make up my mind. That's entirely on me. I'm very indecisive with stuff like this. They come in packs of two, and this is the second pack I've bought. I'll put it on and use it for a while, then take it off, and then a little bit later, I'll add another one and take it off. That's on me. I can be indecisive with stuff like that, but right now, it's cool. As for scheduling and my calendar, I use Fantastical. I have it on my iPad, my iPhone, my MacBook Pro. It's all synced. This thing is kind of a lifesaver for me. It does what any calendar app is gonna do, but it uses this sort of like natural text interpretation thing. If I need to add something, I just hit the plus button and just start typing out in normal, you know, like how I would say it out loud, and it can interpret that and translate it and put it into my calendar exactly when, exactly what time, even the location. It's just awesome. You can also set up recurring events for any kind of weekly routine or appointment, anything that's going to be consistent week to week or month to month, however it works for you. My kids are in two different schools with two different schedules. My wife is an RN with a schedule that changes every week. She's now back in college to further her degree, all online. My daughter has occupational therapy once a week. She has speech therapy once a week. My son is in jiu-jitsu twice a week. Factor all of that in with my own appointments, my own schedule of filming YouTube videos, making photos for myself, having calls with clients, responding to messages and emails and comments. It's a little bit chaotic, so without Fantastical, where everything is out there and it's all consistent, I don't think I would be able to function. And last but not least in this kind of productivity space is task management, and this is something I've always preferred to do with pen and paper. I've had basically daily checklists for well over a decade now, probably since I was in high school. It's just a really simple way to keep me productive, to keep me on task, and so I don't forget anything. I'd always have field notes or any kind of notebook in my back pocket with a pen, and I would just constantly be adding to that, checking things off my list. It's also just a really satisfying thing as well. I've just always preferred pen and paper for that, and I've tried a number of different task management or to-do list apps, but digital to-do lists have just never worked for me until I tried Things. It's not a free app, so I was really hesitant to try it because I've known how my track record has been with other apps, but honestly, I don't know what it is about this app. It's different. It just works. I don't know if it's the UI or the customization or just how it all works, but I've been using it for a few weeks now on the iPad and I really love it. I ended up getting it on my phone as well to sync it all together. And it just works. I really enjoy using it. It's easy to schedule and move things around as my schedule is always changing. I'm loving it right now. Again, I've been using it for a few weeks, so I would recommend it. If a year from now I'm back to using pen and paper, I guess don't be surprised. Fun stuff. Of course, I use the iPad for a million other things that everyone else uses an iPad for. So I've got all of my different streaming apps on there. I like to have something like that on in the background while I'm editing or folding laundry, doing stuff around the house, that kind of thing. Anybody else actually watch just by listening, whether it be YouTube videos or movies or shows or anything like that? I find myself doing that a lot more than listening to music. I don't know why, but that's always how it's been for me. Elliot also has his own folder full of games on the iPad because a lot of the times during the week, I will pick him up from preschool and he'll come back here and hang out with me in the office for a bit. So while he's here, he's usually playing Goat Simulator or Sonic the Hedgehog or anything else. Procreate is a really fun app that I like to kind of just doodle and sketch in, but I actually also use it for work as well for my YouTube thumbnails. A lot of people have messaged and commented asking what kind of font I use in a lot of my thumbnails. That's just in Procreate of me using my own handwriting, so that's all that is. And that's really kind of the gist of how I use the iPad in my day-to-day life. Obviously, I do a lot of emails on there as well, just using the standard mail app. I haven't really tried many others, but it always just kind of works for me. With iPad OS and also the Magic Keyboard and the little trackpad, there's just so many different quick shortcuts and gestures that you can do that I've just found myself like learning how to use the iPad and navigate through it with all these different quick shortcuts and gestures that I don't even have to think about it now. It just blends in seamlessly with my day-to-day routine. There's just so much I love about it. I'm trying to think of all the different things that, you know, I'd like to share. The form factor is great. I can take this with me anywhere. I don't have the cellular version. I should mention that this is just the Wi-Fi version, and that's worked well enough for me. Most of the time I have access to Wi-Fi, but if I'm ever in a place where I can't, using my phone as a hotspot and then connecting to that, that's always worked well enough for me that I've never felt the need to actually pay the extra to get the cellular version. The Apple Pencil is great. It's super enjoyable to use. It's actually how I relearned how to like write and hold a pencil a couple years ago when I got sick and was dealing with paralysis and limited mobility in my hands and arms. Using pen and paper and constantly scribbling out something because I completely messed up, that got old pretty much instantly. So I started using the Apple Pencil to kind of retrain myself how to write. And ever since then, that's kind of what I guess converted me over to the whole digital note-taking space, because before that I always preferred pen and paper, but this is a nice combo. And again, the Magic Keyboard, it's amazing to use, although I've got to say, the material of this, like the keys, all of that feels great. The material itself is just the worst. It feels like okay, it's not like the feeling of it, you know, kind of like bothers me. It might to some people because it is a really weird finish, but just look at it. I mean, it looks like one of my kids' iPad, well, it doesn't look that bad. Their iPad cases are, yeah, I just hate how this thing smudges up. I want to cover it with stickers just to kind of work around that, but I'm about the same with stickers as I am with the paper-like screen protectors. I put them on and then I take them off within a week, so yeah, I don't know. I don't like ending things on a negative note though, so this thing is great. It's flawed, but it's great, just like people. But that is gonna do it for this video. I really hope this was helpful. If you've been on the fence about an iPad Pro or curious what it would look like to fit in your life, this is how I use it. If you have any suggestions or thoughts of your own, leave them in the comments down below. But that's it for today. I love you guys. I'll see you next time.